Now it's time for Money Matters. Matt Dicken, CEO and founder of Strategic Wealth Designers, is with us.
And as we roll into the holidays, some may want to give a child or grandchild a non-traditional gift, a college savings plan. And we hear a lot about these 529s. But Matt, is that the best way to save for college?
Well, the reason why you hear about 529 plans so much is they are kind of hard to beat. You put money into them, it's going to grow tax-free, and as long as you use the money for education, you get to take it out tax-free. One of the big things that changed recently that not everybody is aware of is you can now use 529 plans for K through 12, whereas it used to just be for college education and beyond, but now almost any age you can benefit from having a 529
plan. Meaning for tuition or expenses?
Correct.
Yeah.
I didn't realize they'd made that change. Yeah. So what about other alternatives out there?
Yeah, if you don't want to use the 529 plan, because one drawback is the money has to be used for tuition and fees, expenses, things like that. But let's say you want to buy the child or the grandchild a car to get them through school or an off-campus apartment, something like that. You would want to then use something else, maybe a Roth IRA in the name of a parent or a grandparent if they're not using it for their retirement themselves, maybe municipal bonds, certain insurance strategies. It really just depends on the age of the child and what it is that you're trying to accomplish.
You know, tuition does keep going up. There's no question about that. And what's at play there? It's faster than inflation.
It is. You're correct. It's about double what inflation typically is what the cost of college tuition goes up by. Some of it, of course, is just normal inflation, but I think the rest of it is the fact that universities are trying to figure out how much they can charge. You know, we all go to college now, right? We're all told that you should go to college at least. It didn't used to be that way. So they're just trying to figure out what the market will bear and what type of tuition they can get away with charging.
A lot of students want these amenities now that that some of us didn't have back in the day, right?
Right, yeah. Now, one thing you could do to try and reduce the cost of college education expenses is maybe go 2 years to maybe a community college before going to a major university. That's what I did myself. Or maybe even working a little bit through college. And maybe not the most popular thing to do, but even if you have to delay graduation by a semester or two, that certainly won't hurt in the long run.
Important considerations. Thank you.
No problem.
And to learn more from Matt on this topic or other business news, visit WKYT.com/moneymatters.
And if you have something you want us to discuss, send an email to news@WKYT.com and we'll talk about it live on the air.